Welcome back, Orleans, to more Dragon Age Origins.
I've been sick for days. You should have seen me last week.
Ancestors watch over your path.
Not bad for a surfacer.
Fine to see you here, Warden. A number of people have told me they hope to see you in the Provings. It's a rare opportunity to fight against someone so exotically trained. In fact, a few were hoping you'd take part in some informal action.
Informal? You mean illegal?
Assembly restricted, not illegal. All that ritual lets nobles rationalize it's not a blood sport. They don't like commoners using the arena for petty squabbles. Some of us prefer an honest spectacle. And sometimes someone needs a good beating, and all that talking gets in the way.
I'm game. What do you have in mind?
Say the word and I'll line up a team from one of the younger houses. They don't often get a chance to test themselves in the Provings. They're a hungry bunch who employ unusual tactics. Understand that there's no concern for fairness here. Your battles will be hard won. The younger houses are interested in unorthodox tactics. Many hire mercenaries to augment traditional strengths. Anything goes is a fair description. We give small payouts, maybe a bonus from time to time. But this isn't about money. It's about skill and the chance to show it.
I'm gonna try fighting these guys one more time. Because I had a bad go at it the first time.
I assure you.
Well, if I had potions, I could definitely do this. I just don't have any goddamn mana, so once my chick runs out of mana, that's it. I just need to go get some mana potions. Healing potions, but... This is going way differently than the first time. Fuck it, just drink a lesser. Guys on shale shit! Get off me rocks! Get off me talking rocks! That's what you get. You shouldn't try to focus, fuck the game hoarder.
You've earned a portion of the receipts. Let me know if you want to go again.
So we can just keep battling, apparently, here.
I'll be here.
I needed revenge. I guess the payout gets bigger and bigger. We'll come back when we're big badasses near the end of the game and stomp everybody. Lug-Lug just wanted revenge. So I can, I've won the honor of Harrowmont, who we could continue with. However, I'm just looking around here for shit to do.
That was a good fight. Miaja learned a lot from you.
So did Luke, John.
Or we can probably still go with the other guy. The Prince Bellon.
Extraordinary as you claim.
They all but rule over my homeland. Do you find that extraordinary?
If true, are they so powerful simply because they are very good at what they do? Or is there some secret to their power?
If there were a secret, it would only remain so if it were not told.
You are no longer bound to such a code. Or do you believe their wrath will be greater than it already is, should you speak out of turn?
It may be that I simply do not wish to tell you. You get the most delightful wrinkle in your brow when you are curious.
I see. You are impossibly frustrating. You know this.
I do. It is part of my charm, or so I'm told.
Greetings, and welcome to Garen Garrison's luxury goods shop.
Got backpacks?
Wow, there are a lot of you. And I've never seen one of those before. The things they come up with. What was I saying?
Have a look at my shop, I hope.
Right. Yeah, I have some lovely things here. Lyrium enhanced, of course.
Holy shitballs, really? A one-handed dagger for 148 gold? Pretty sweet, though. Dexterity, health regen, 3 damage. That'd be great for Zevran to dual wield. But we already have 2 meleeers. Life Giver for 87 gold, plus 10 constitution, 3 health regen in combat, plus 10 health regeneration while exploring. 3 armor, plus 20 to healing effects. That's pretty boss right there. That's also very expensive. That'd be a lot of my monies. I think we'll keep exploring for better items. So to the diamond quarter. And shine bright like a diamond. Game Horror about to hit the gym. Got some Alpha GX7 pre-workout. About to induce myself. Bear with me as I pre-rage. Demon is ready. Gotta have my pre-workout. Especially after a weekend of getting thrashed.
News of the hour. Lord Balin promises radical changes that will offend the ancient paragons. Have our traditions no value?
Well, we could go to Harrowmont right now. Let's go see what Baylan has to offer.
Lord Baylan is the voice of change and defense. Lord Harrowmont is the voice of stagnation and ruin.
Neither one of them is just standing out as the evil of the two, but I have a feeling the prince is definitely the douche. The main guy had a fucking dragon that I had to slay. Oh, he's not even in here. He's in the... He's at the meeting chamber.
You're awfully bold, walking right up to me after coming out against Prince Baylan and approving. You do know who I am. I'm Vartak Gavorn, the prince's chief advisor.
Well, you're representing a loser. I'm not sure we want to say that. I'd like to meet Prince Baylan.
Well, you have an unusual way of showing it. Why would the prince possibly meet with someone who came out publicly against him?
And now Harrowmont, trust me, unlike your other spies.
I see your point. Had you come to us first, Harrowmont would have suspected you.
Exactly!
He has no reason to...
Welcome to Lugnut's world!
...other than his champion. On the proving grounds and off.
Bah! Why are we even discussing this? Fool's errand upon fool's errand. That is all it ever seems to get up to.
Are you saying you'd infiltrate his ranks for us? Let the prince know what's happening on the inside?
Just tell me what you want to know, but I'll need Balin's support in return.
For your treaty, right? I heard about that. Sure. If Balin's king, he'll help you against the Blight. If it turns out you helped him get there. If you really want Balin's trust, you'll have to prove your loyalty to Harrowmont as just an act. What has he asked you to do next?
I don't know. Hasn't told me.
Then find out and come tell me. If you want to be of use to the prince, this is your chance to prove it. Stay away from Lord Helmy and Lady Dace. I'm sure we can find a better way to prove your worth. I look forward to seeing you again.
Alright. Well, pissing off Shale. Which isn't good. I'm not really getting bonus points for other people. We'll just run through it this way and see how it works. We can always reload.
The hour. Support Lord Harrowmont at your own peril. Lord Baylan is
But if we're just getting disapproval from all of her companions, that's not gonna be too good.
Can I get you a ladder?
Perhaps I could have a try at that.
Cool. Just break up on in here. Really? Can't even get in the chest.
If you're looking for Lord Doolin Forender, you'll find him at Tapstones, taking his evening drink.
I feel this is probably the evil way to go about doing things, is to lure someone into trusting me and then backstab the shit out of them. All right. It's more or less what we're doing. Plus, we got to fight in the arena, so... Shedding blood is Luglug's number one thing to do. Without bloodshed, he's like a fish out of water. Tapsters. Holy shit. There's Dylan.
Atrasvala, champion. I hear your performance in the proving was nothing short of amazing. There can no longer be any doubt where your sympathies lie. If you're ready, Lord Harrowmont will see you now.
Excellent, lead the way!
His lordship is looking forward to meeting you.
I'm a shady-ass Grey Warden.
His lordship appreciates your support.
Attack!
I appreciate what you have done, Warden. And I apologize for putting one of your rank through such trials.
Oh yeah, I don't like this guy. Fuck him.
I am Lord Pyrell Harrowmont, and I thank you for your efforts to help me preserve King Endrin's throne.
Why would Endrin prefer you over his own son?
You may not know the story, but Balin is actually the youngest of three. Endrin's eldest, Trian, was murdered in the Deep Roads not a year ago. His middle son was found standing over the body and was exiled. But I've always found it suspicious that Balin knew just where to look. Endrin loved his sons too much to voice such suspicions. But he knew Balin's only interest in ruling was to further his own power.
Balin's definitely the asshole here.
Balin's men say you planted those suspicions.
Balin resents me because I did not believe his setup. I wanted a full investigation, a trial, not this knee-jerk reaction. It speaks poorly of Balin that Endrin himself was the first to think that he should not be trusted.
You'd believe you'd a better king than Balin?
I have never sought the throne. My role was to serve Endrin, first as his advisor, then as an elected Desher in the Assembly. Harrowmont has never been king, and I always assumed Trian would rule after his father. But both Endrin and my colleagues have asked me to step up, and I will not back down when Orzammar needs me.
Just spit it out! What do we need to do to get your help as king?
Ultimately, the Assembly decides what troops to send. If they no longer fear civil war, they'll have no reason to hold back. If you want my support to count, I will have to be king. And right now, there is no sure way to get there. Have you heard of a woman named Jarvia and the criminal cartel she runs?
No, but I want to bang her now. You could say we have some history.
You would know better than I the many ways the castless hide from authorities in Dust Town. I hoped you might still have old contacts who could help dig out Jarvia.
My sister is Balin's concubine. If you become king...
Your sister, I see. This is new to me. What happens to her is more House Hadouken's concern.
Hadouken!
But I promise no harm will come to her by my doing.
I don't really want to help you then. I'll have to think about this.
Then I ask you, think quickly. Balin's schemes multiply by the hour, and the sooner this is done, the closer I will be to the throne. Let me know when you make your decision.
Okay, gotta go rat you out now.
I don't know what happens if I just flat out attack that dude. I could beat everyone in here.
News of the hour. Support Lord Balin at your peril. Evident.
Like how they have their own little guys outside of their houses.
The Legion of the Dead Warriors secretly wear Prince Balin.
Private public speakers.
Our prince has Orzammar's deadliest warriors
behind.
Did you talk to Harriman? What does he want you to do?
He wants me to stop the Carta!
That's a good plan. If he can claim credit for stopping the Carta, Harriman will be in Golden with a lot of Deshers.
It's a little odd, though, given his associations with Dust Town smugglers.
Tell me what you want me to do!
Do what Harriman asked. Stop Jarvia. Let him claim he was behind it.
It will be hard enough to believe him when I have solid evidence. His cousin supplies the Carta with their lyrium.
You want me to frame him?
These papers show ties between the Carta and young Harville Harriman. If you ensure they are found in Jarvia's possession, I guarantee the Prince will want to talk to you. And don't bother looking for Lord Helmy and Lady Dace. This is a far better way to prove your worth.
All right. Find a way to Jarvia's hideout. Perhaps you'll be able to find some clues in Dust Town. A lot of fucking quests here. Rika!
I can't believe you went and fought approving. Approving for that wretched Harriman. And I told Balin we could trust you.
Bitch, you will stand down or I'll cut your fucking head off. You stupid slut. Alright, I like the way this is going. Shale's just gonna have to deal with it. So I guess we go tell Harriman that we're down. We're DTF.
News of the hour.
Down to fuck up Jarvia.
Lord Harriman insinuates against the game.
Holy shit, I'm ass backwards.
News of the hour.
Welcome again. Have you considered my offer?
I'll deal with Jarvia. Be ready to help against the Blight.
Do this, and I promise if I take the throne, I will not stop until the Assembly sends your troops. Look for Jarvia in Dust Town. Do whatever it takes to see that justice...
Oh, I will! Don't you worry about that.
Should've got some gold from him. Prepayment. But no option for that in the dialogue, sadly. I could have used a couple hundred gold pieces prepayment so I could go buy that Life Giver ring. Uglug wants that shit. That's a good fucking ring. Too bad Shale can't wear more shit. It's the only thing I don't like about her. She is still a much better fighter than Sten was. Okay, finally going to Dust Town. Whoa, shit! Harriman has succored the Warden. Balin will not allow it. These guys are against me even though they must not know I'm working incognito. Making this difficult on me. need to get this bitch some potions. This is ridiculous. I knew Shale was going down. I ain't getting my mage too, motherfucker. Penalty to max mile to remove this energy, use an injury kit or visit. Uh-oh. We got our first real injury. But Shale got a level. More tanking. Bonuses damage, physical resistance. This is passive, so this is great. Warriors on here. Yeah, of course I gotta get this, right? Physical resistance, bonus to critical chance. I'm not really using stone aura a whole lot. Yeah, I'll just go warrior. Greater Lyrium potion. Who the fuck sells potions around here?
I want that surface wealth coming back to us, Balin's ascension willing.
Your allegiance to Balin is clear. Why?
Not your business, but I see where the gold is. He's the traditional pick, yet he wants a new way, whether some like it or not. I'll take your gold. You're good for that.
I like this guy's style.
May the Maker guide your way.
Why do the poor not rise up against their betters? This I never understood.
All right, new location, so of course we're going to be bombarded with codexes and fucking these assholes, apparently. And what the fuck are you doing, Shale? Did you really just fucking ice the whole crew? You are fucking terrible.
Look like any guardsman I ever saw, and that's not much of a uniform.
I'm Luglug, the Grey Warden.
Oh, you looking for a chance to bring in some coin?
Could always.
I have that opportunity. Especially for someone with a few connections above ground.
I'd have to hear what you're asking.
Human kings, you know, they make these ridiculous laws. Like about who gets to buy and sell Lyrium, the sacred gift the stone provides us to show her love. No law should regulate that. The laws are meant to keep mages away from the stuff, so there's always buyers in the Circle Tower. I got one man named Godwin. He's expecting a delivery of a stone's weight. You want an investment opportunity? I could see fit to, say, sell you that lyrium instead at the reasonable price of 50 sovereigns. You can keep it, or, since you can travel freely from here, sell it to Godwin, who you know is buying. And, if you bring back his return order, I could pay you, say, 20 sovereigns as a finder's fee.
50? It's a bit much when you've got no options. 40!
You haggle like a merchant born. Deal. Here's the lyrium, then. You, probably don't want to take it out of the box. I'll be waiting for the next order somewhere out of sight. Say, just around the corner.
Damn, 40 gold? This investment better pay off or I'm gonna be really fucking pissed. Anyways, folks, that wraps it up for this episode. Stay tuned for some more Dragon Age Origins.